The first topic under this session is testing's contribution to success, where we will see how testing at different level contributes to success. The different level of software development cycles are requirement level, where software requirements are written. Then comes the design level, where design is made. After that comes the coding level, where code is implemented. And then finally comes the complete software, which is ready for testing. Now with example, we will try to understand how testing at these levels contribute to success of overall product. So now let's discuss the first level of testing during development process, and that is the requirement level. Here we will understand how testing during the requirement level will contribute to the success of whole project. In this level, we start by reviewing the requirement. Reviewing is nothing but static testing. So we are performing static testing on the requirements. We are also doing this to detect the defect in these work products. Here, of course, the work product are just the requirement. So why are we reviewing this requirement? Is to reduce the risk of incorrect or unstable functionality being developed, which means if there is something wrong or incorrect in the requirement and we don't spot it, then that is how the entire project will be developed. And this is what we have to stop by performing testing on the requirement. To understand this, let's have a look into the software development levels. These are the different levels in software development. First, you have the user requirement. Then you have a system requirement. Now, if we don't correct the error at this level, it goes on and becomes part of the global design and detailed design, both of which will be wrong. And eventually we will have a software that does not work correctly. So this is why if we correct the requirement at this stage, the rest of the process will carry out without error. And this is why we say testing at requirement contributes to the success of product. Now let's discuss the second level of testing during development process, and that is at the design level. At design level, there will be a system design. Our job is to do a review on it. Since there is no code, we cannot run it. Therefore, we review it, which is a static testing technique. When we do this review, it will increase team members' understanding. So, whether it is a tester, developer, or any other process guy, everyone will have the same understanding after this review. If everyone has the same understanding or knowledge, it will help to reduce the risk of fundamental design defects. So, a review of system design will reduce the risk of fundamental design defects. Now, let's go back to our chart. Right now, we are at the global or detailed design stage. If we carry out our testing here and catch the mistake, then it will not go to the implementation stage. We will send the correct software to the dynamic testing and the product will be a success. If we don't do testing, then we will send a faulty software for dynamic testing. And then we will be forced to go back two steps to find the error. And for this, we have to spend additional time and effort. I hope that it is obvious now why testing at design level is so important. It's because it contributes to the success of the whole project. Now let's discuss the third level of testing during development process, and that is the coding level. So how does testing coding contributes to success? In the coding level, you have code under development. The code is being developed and you will perform a static testing on it. The intention with this is to increase the understanding of the piece of code. By doing this, we reduce the risk of defect within the code. So if there are any defect, we can find them out by reviewing the code through static testing. Now let's see an example to understand how reviewing code can find defect. Suppose this is the requirement. Check window moves up within 10 milliseconds once the button is pressed. For this requirement, the developer has written this code. Try and see if you can tell what's the mistake in this code. The function looks right, but see here. The developer has written if button is pressed for 10 milliseconds or less, then the window will move up. The requirement was for window to move up within 10 milliseconds and not at 10 milliseconds. The developer has introduced this equal to sign which changes the result. Now, the window might not move up unless exactly 10 milliseconds have passed. So this is how performing testing at coding level can reveal mistake in the code and contribute to the success of whole project. Now let's discuss the final level of testing during development process, and that is the software level. So let's find out how testing at software contributes to the success of the project. Once the software is ready, we verify and validate the software. Now that the software is functional and the code is ready, we can perform dynamic testing on it. Once we perform the dynamic testing, we detect failure that might otherwise have been missed. If we don't do the testing at this level, then there is a fair chance that we will miss some error, and they will finally be discovered when the software is in operational use. Next is removing the defect that causes the failure. So we will fix the problem because of which the software is failing. This is where the debugging process comes into picture, which we discussed previously. The tester finds the error and tells the developer, who fixes the problem and sends it back to the tester to confirm that error is gone. And by doing all this, our software will meet the stakeholders' need, and it will meet the customer or the user's requirement, and that means everyone using the software will be happy. So this is how testing at software level helps the product succeed. Thank you.